So, hey, I'm David. I'm currently working for Plus Systems and I'm a KDE developer, mainly work currently on Plasma. Now, some of you might be thinking, what the hell are Power Query Files even about? So, I want to start with what do we want when using a computer? We want that the computer adapts its power usage and performance to what I'm doing. When I'm on a train and I'm reading some emails or PDFs, then I want that my battery of the laptop lasts as long as possible. So even if the train has delays and I miss my other train, that I can keep using my laptop. But when I want to play a video game, I want the maximum performance so I get no frame lags and can enjoy the game without being interrupted by stuttering. In general, the default setup the kernel does of your system or how it controls your hardware is a compromise, even though your CPU can clock up and down or can. Other parameters can be adapted to the current usage. But even though these tend to be a good thing for the general use case and do a good job, with manual configuration, you can eke out a bit more in each area. You can get eke out a bit more performance or eke out a bit more battery life. So we want to now modify these for on our PC. So we have to see how we can do that. So the problem here is that in general, depending on your hardware, it's different how you do that. It's different to configure your GPU to compare to your CPU. And in general, it's also different depending on the vendor of your hardware. For example, I want to change the governor of my CPU to get better performance or to save battery. Then I see here, I go to the documentation or man page and see all the different options I can set, the governor, and the frequency and so on. But then I have an Intel CPU. They're using the P-State driver. It has additional options. Like now I have to know how do they relate to the other settings and what do I want there. And now I've only configured my CPU. And now I want to configure my graphics card. Luckily, I have an NVIDIA graphics card using the proprietary driver, even though it's not open, but I want to play games with it. Luckily, they have a UI tool for that. So I can select there quite easily. I don't have to pipe to files, but I have no idea what's adaptive, what's auto, what's the difference. I don't know. But when I have an AMD card, I have another set of options. I screenshotted here only one. So in the end, this is too complicated for the end user. I just want to say to my PC, I want the best performance available, or I want to save as much energy as possible. There's a nice new kernel feature called Platform Profiles for that. It's exposed by the ACPI interface if your PC or mainboard supports it. And it allows you to tell it, I want you to be as quiet as possible, or I want the best performance, and it will adapt the performance of the CPU, the fan profile, the thermal management, how hot the device is allowed to get. So to do what you want. For example, for this is for example, Lenovo laptops, they will allow higher temperature if you're in performance mode and it has a sensor to detect if it's on a desk or not, and it will allow that. But if you're moving it, it will think it's on your lap and will not allow to be as hot as possible in order not to burn you. But still, I, as a user, that's not really comfortable writing to this file. For that, there's a new central project called Power Profiles Daemon, which is intended to be the central daemon managing this state of the system. Of the five available profiles you saw before, it extracts them even further into only three: power saving, normal balanced performance, and the maximum performance mode. In addition to that, it can also execute actions when the profile is changed, for example, disabling use BFast charging of a device plugged into when you go to power saving mode. And it uses this platform profile interface when it's available. Now I spent some time integrating that into Plasma. I want to show you screenshots of that. And I have to thank Kai Uwe here because he started this work and I basically only had to fill in the blanks to finish it up. Here we see the battery applet. And there is added a new control where you simply can select the power profile. And here you see currently performance mode is not available because the computer is running too hot and will not let you enable performance mode any longer. This is as mostly finished, needs some polishing up, and I expect it to be available in Plasma 5.23. Here is the energy KCM, where you can see it's possible to automatically configure automatically changing the power profile if you, for example, unplug your laptop or plug it in again. So you can leave it unchanged or switch to power save, for example. Now a future feature which is really cool, which I implemented into the upstream power profile daemon project. There was API already planned but not implemented that a application could request enabling of a certain power profile. So for example, if you start a game, it can that says activate performance mode, and as long as the game runs, your PC will be in performance mode. And if it's stopped again, it will automatically go back to the one you selected before. I already implemented it also on the Plasma side, but obviously this depends on when the upstream work is merged, which currently is blocked. Yeah. This is all I had to say about this. Was just a quick update about the work I have been doing on this front. Another area where this could be interesting is last year, David Edmondson did a talk about the foreground booster, where we could then imagine having this also in there. If an application is boosted, then we could also automatically switch the power profile. Thank you and enjoy your break.